Welcome to Racial Scale Modeling. This is part 6 of Revell's Vasa. Scale is 1 to 150. In this part, I'm predominantly concentrating on the bowsprit, making up that mast and painting it and so on. I'm also going to be starting off by finishing off a part of the hull. So let's jump into this and see how well I get on. Before I get into the mast, there's a couple of things I have to do first, and that is paint up the corners and place them onto the ship. So the base colour for this is Revell Aqua Colour 31 Fiery Red. Now, this lot was painted near the beginning of the build, hence why you still see the deck there unpainted. But like in the past, I thought it was better to show all in one sequence, not necessarily in the right order. So it just makes more sense. So the next colour is Revell Aqua Colour 94 Gold. Moving on to the next colour, which is Revell Aqua Colour 35 Flesh. Now, these are all painted in the same way as the stern decorations. They're just the corner parts that I'm actually painting here. Next is Revell Aqua Colour 360 Fern Green. And lastly, Revell Aqua Colour 331 Purple Red. And that's all the basic colours I made so far. Basically, these are little figures that run down the cornicing of this particular part of the ship. It's, as I said, it's the same thing on the stern or the decorations. It's just the corner parts. The corners do have to be made up, though. There's two halves of them. Each corner is slightly different, so it's important that I make sure I got these done in the proper order. And while I'm waiting for the colours to dry, I may as well start the next part of the build. And these are the stanchions that hold the shrouds. So the first paint is 09 Arthrosite by Revell Aqua Colour. And these are for the stays that hold the rope in place. And then the base colour is 382 Wood Brown. And they were able to go on quite easily. There's little location holes at the side of the ship for these to fit into. Each one is slightly different, so if you're doing the kit, make sure that you locate the proper part for the correct area. There are six in total, three on each side. The two larger ones near the front of the ship, the bow, and one very small one near the stern of the ship. And next is the corners, now that they're all dry. And they just place on this location point for each one. There is slight difference in sizes, so dry fit them before you place them in, because you don't want to get them the wrong way around. For instance, that one I placed in there, that was the wrong one. That should have been a smaller one. But as I say, I was only dry fitting them at this time. So now going on to the mast constructions. Now everything's been given a base coat of Revell Aqua Colour 382. This part here is the flagpole. So the colour that I'm using for the main mast is Revell Aqua Colour 17 African Brown. And so the wood brown and this African brown is going to be the two main colours that I'll be using on the mast. So when you see the two different contrasts of colours, the darker one is the Revell Aqua Colour 382 Wood Brown. So therefore the lighter one is the 17 African Brown. There is a couple of variations as I'm building the mast. There's a couple of little bits of colour going on, which I will highlight as I'm building them. But just bear in mind, that's the two main colours. It's not necessary to repeat them every time. The next colour is Revell Aqua Colour 381 Brown Silk. And this is just for the end caps of the mast and the connectors for the mast, just to give it another contrast of wood colour. Next, for the ease of time, I'm painting these mast cross trees. Are all getting painted on the sprue, and I'll touch them up as I place them onto the mast. This is the bowsprit, and I'm just putting on a fresh coat of paint. Now it's came off the sprue, I'm just touching it up a little bit for all the little connection points that I've had to clean off. I've done all this off camera because it's quite tedious work to show you all the time. So it's just cleaning up the unit before placing it on. and then retouching the paintwork. So as you can see, I'm putting in the lighter colour of paint. Now this is the African brown colour that I'm placing on to the main mast here. As you point out, I've never actually seen a bowsprit constructed this way. I've never seen one with a mast leading up from the bowsprit. I mean, it's almost like it's the forward mast, but it can't be. So I don't know the proper terminology for this little mast that's going on here. And I'm just putting in more detail with the 3-in-1 brown silk. Here I'm using Revell colour 89 beige, and these are for the coils of rope that are, well, the connecting ropes that hold down the bowsprit. They've done it in a solid mould on this one. Sometimes they just tell you to place the rope on, but this one's a solid mould, and it actually helps anchor the bowsprit when placing it onto the model itself. Next, I'm using Revell colour 06 tar black, and this is for the shrouds that go up the mast. Now the instructions don't call for this actual colour; they call for a light brown colour, Revell colour 87, I believe it is. But for me, it's too close to the wooden colour for it to stand out. Now I could have painted these in a beige or hemp colour, but I think they look better in black, so that's what I done. Also, the 3-in-1 brown silk that I'm using here is for the stays at the end of the shrouds. That colour would get lost, and in the well, that detail would get lost. I should say, if I painted them in the hemp or beige colour. This is me painting them in the beige, just trying it out to see if it would make much difference, if it would stand out. And the stay detail really does get lost. That's why I kept with the black in the end. So the first part to be attached is the mast cross tree, and this sits right at the bottom of this upper part of the mast, so where the bowsprit makes this mast. And the mast itself has one sail yard to go on. Most bowsprits have a boom, which this is similar getting attached to this, but I think this actually might be another sail yard. I'm not 100% sure. It sort of looks like a sail yard and not a boom, but as I said, this is a strange configuration for me for the bowsprit, so I'm not 100% sure. And all that remains to go on are the shrouds. Now the shrouds get anchored on the cross tree. There's three location points to anchor the shrouds onto. On this particular kit, the stays are in various lengths to fit the actual cross tree. If you do it, you may have to trim them up slightly just to get them to fit. I think it was probably designed this way, depending on how the builder goes about the actual kit itself. So make sure you dry fit them first, and I would say, when you're fitting them, anchor them at the bottom first before you even attempt to secure the top half to the mast itself. And as you can see, they can be quite tricky to fit. It's just the nature and the shape of them. They have to go at the right angle to lay onto the mast. These ones are easier than most because the top part has little locations to lean onto the its opposite half, which gives you a good idea where they should go onto the mast. And this is where I'll bring the video to an end. There's quite a lot done to get to this point, so I don't really want to start on it the next mast. I don't think I'd fit it all in into the video. So if you haven't done so already, why don't you check out the channel for my other builds? If you hit the notification bell, you'll be kept up to date with not only this video, but of course all my future builds as well. Hit that like button, don't be afraid to leave a comment, and of course you can share the video. But for now, thank you all very much for watching. Bye bye.